Hi, this is Darshan Dave. Today, IFH explores what makes Mohammad Rafi India's greatest singer. Na fankar tujhsa tere baad aaya, zamane ko jisne deewana banaya, mushkil hai tujhko kabhi bhool paana, Mohammad Rafi, tujhe hamesha yaad rakhega zamana. The above verse beautifully captures the larger-than-life persona of Indian film music industry's undisputed monarch, Mohammad Rafi Sahab. Today, 41 years have passed since he bid adieu on 31st July 1980. Yet, despite such a long part, his memory continues to pursue. From dawn to dusk, his mellifluous voice keeps Rafi alive, resonating through the radio, television, and social media, reminding, "Mujhko mere baad, zamana dhoondega."
मुझको मेरे बाद माना ढूंढेगा
True. Decades have passed, but the Indian film industry has failed to find an equivalent of the caliber of Rafi Sahab. The generations have attempted to copy his style, from Mahendra Kapoor to Anwar to Shabbir Kumar to Mohammad Aziz to Sonu Nigam, and the list is endless. But none could match the inimitable style of legendary Mohammad Rafi. Even today, songs of Rafi are remixed and music companies are minting millions of rupees.
Tum mujhe yun bhula na paoge.
Winner of 6 Filmfare Awards and 1 National Film Award, Padma Shri Mohammad Rafi is the brightest jewel in the crown of Indian film music. On his 41st death anniversary, Mansoor Khan of Indian film history pays Mohammad Rafi a tribute and tries to explore what makes Rafi India's greatest singer. Well, before Mohammad Rafi entered the film industry, the industry had a handful of singers. Apart from the legendary K.L. Sehgal, none of the singers had studied music. None had an aptitude for playback singing. Mohammad Rafi was India's first trained playback singer. Rafi studied music as a child under the guidance of stalwart Indian classical gurus like Ustad Abdul Wahid Khan, Pandit Jeevan Lal Mattu, Ustad Bade Ghulam Ali Khan Sahab, Firoz Nizami, and others. Mohammad Rafi displayed his genius as an exceptional singer at a very young age, when he was just 13 years old. According to Mohammad Rafi's brother Abdul Hamid, Rafi had a passion for music. Once Bollywood's famous singer K.L. Sehgal was to give a public performance in Lahore. But due to power failure, the sound system went dead and he did not sing. The restless audience started creating chaos. The organizers were in a tight spot. Hence, to save the organizers from the turmoil, Mohammad Rafi was sent on stage to sing. A 13-year-old Mohammad Rafi was excited and began singing without a mic. Rafi's high-pitched voice took the audience by surprise. A pin-drop silence prevailed while Rafi sang. The audience was left enchanted by Rafi's golden voice. It so happened that when Mohammad Rafi was performing on the stage, he was noticed by famous music director Shyam Sundar, who had specially arrived to listen to K.L. Sehgal, but was left spellbound by Mohammad Rafi's mellifluous voice. Soon after the stage performance, Shyam Sundar approached Rafi and signed him to sing song in his Punjabi film Gul Baloch. The song was Soniye Ni Heeriye Ni.
Goriye Ni Heeriye Ni Teri Yaad Ne Aana Sataya.
Soon Rafi became a name to reckon in the Lahore film industry and Lahore radio, and later arrived in Mumbai. Mohammad Rafi was a master in Indian Shastriya Sangeet in Hindi cinema. Rafi was noticed by music maestro Naushad. He gave Rafi a break as a chorus singer in his film Pehle Aap in 1944. The song was Hindustan Ke Hum Hai, Hindustan Hamara.
Hindustan Ke Hum Hai, Hindustan Hamara.
Naushad was overwhelmed by Rafi's command in Indian Shastriya Sangeet. Hence, Naushad dared to experiment and gave Mohammad Rafi a solo song in Mehboob Khan's blockbuster film Anmol Ghadi in 1946. The song was Tera Khilona Toota Balak, Tera Khilona Toota.
तेरा खिलौना टूटा बालक तेरा खिलौना टूटा.
The song became an instant hit. However, what impressed Naushad was Rafi's ability to adapt to the artist singing on the screen. Rafi molded his voice with apt expressions and emotions of the hero. Naushad was happy as Indian cinema had discovered India's first true playback singer. Thus, Mohammad Rafi and Naushad had a long-standing association. Naushad not only recognized Rafi's unparalleled singing skills, but explored Rafi's voice to the ultimate. Naushad made rag-based classical Shastriya Sangeet compositions, which had Indian ethos and the earthy fragrance of Indian folk music. Songs like Man Tadpat Hari Darshan Ko Aaj from Beju Bawra, Suhani Raat Dhal Chuki from Dulari,
Suhani Raat Dhal Chuki,
Hue Hum Jinke Liye Barbaad from Didar,
Hue Hum Jinke Liye Barbaad Wo Humko,
O Dur Ke Musafir from Udan Khatola,
दूर के मुसाफिर,
and मधुबन में राधिका नाचे रे from कोहिनूर,
मधुबन में राधिका नाचे,
जिंदाबाद जिंदाबाद ए मोहब्बत जिंदाबाद from मुगले आजम एटसेट्रा,
जिंदाबाद जिंदाबाद
are examples of Rafi Naushad combination. Mohammad Rafi was equally adept at Western music. Mohammad Rafi brought a radical change to Hindi film music with his association with Shankar Jaikishan. While Naushad explored the classical side of Rafi, Shankar Jaikishan tapped his Western side. With songs like Yahoo, Chahe Koi Mujhe Jangli Kahe from Jangli,
Chahe Koi Mujhe Jangli Kahe,
Aasman Se Aaya Farishta from An Evening in Paris, लाल छड़ी मैदान खड़ी from जानवर,
लाल छड़ी मैदान खड़ी,
शंकर जयकिशन टेक क्रेडिट फॉर मेकिंग रफी कंप्लीटली वाइल्ड एंड नॉटी. दे गेव अ सीरीज ऑफ सुपरहिट सॉन्ग्स इन द हिट फिल्म्स ऑफ द 60s लाइक खुली पलक में झूठा गुस्सा फ्रॉम प्रोफेसर,
जरा ठहरो
तुमने पुकारा और हम चले आए फ्रॉम राजकुमार,
तुमने पुकारा और हम,
बदतमीज कहो या कहो जानवर फ्रॉम बदतमीज,
तमीज कहो या कहो जानवर,
बदन पे सितारे लपेटे हुए फ्रॉम प्रिंस एंड मेनी मोर,
बदन पे सितारे लपेटे हुए.
बिसाइड्स नौशाद एंड शंकर जयकिशन, रफी बिकेम द हॉट फेवरेट ऑफ एवरी म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर. In the 60s, regarded as the golden era of Indian cinema, Rafi was the most sought-after singer. The decade witnessed Mohammad Rafi singing for almost all the top music directors of Bollywood, like S.D. Barman in films Tere Ghar Ke Samne, Guide, Aradhana, to O.P. Nayyar in films Naya Daur, Tumsa Nahi Dekha, Kashmir Ki Kali, Madan Mohan in films like Ghazal, Mamta, Hakikat, to Ravi in films Chaudhvi Ka Chand, Kajal and Do Badan, to Roshan in films like Barsaat Ki Raat, Taj Mahal, Chitralekha, to Khayyam in films like Shola Aur Shabnam, Shagun, Aakhri Khat, and the list is endless. Mohammad Rafi was versatile in voice modulation. The quality that made Rafi distinct from other singers in the race like Mukesh, Manna Day, Talat Mahmood and Kishore Kumar was that Rafi was a versatile singer who could mold his voice to each hero on the screen. For example, Mukesh was best known for his sad songs, while Talat Mahmood had authority in ghazal singing. Manna Day was preferred to sing classical based songs, and Kishore Kumar was known for his playful songs. In stark contrast, Rafi was the only singer whose versatility stretched beyond the imagination. The varied approach he adopted to sing a particular genre for different heroes was so exceptional that film buffs could identify the hero singing the song on the screen by listening to the song on the radio. Rafi had a distinct style for every actor. For Shammi Kapoor, Rafi adopted a peppy voice. Listen to O Haseena Zulfon Wali Jaane Jahan from Teesri Manzil. For Rajendra Kumar, Rafi used a silken voice. Baharon Phool Barsao from Suraj. Similarly, for comedian Johnny Walker, Rafi gave a different twist in his voice that harmonized with the hilarious style of Johnny Walker. Listen to the song Sar Jo Tera Chakraye from Pyasa in 1957. Likewise, Rafi could perfectly synchronize his voice for comedian Mahmood. Listen to the song Hum Kale Hain To Kya Hua Dilwale Hain from Gumnaam. Mohammad Rafi could sing bhajans and ghazals with equal ease. When he sang the bhajans, his voice transformed and the ambience turned divine. Who could forget his bhajans like Brindavan Ke Krishna Kanhaiya from Miss Mary or Sukh Ke Sab Saathi Dukh Mein Na Koi from film Gopi. Similarly, when Rafi Saab sang ghazals, he overtook the exceptional ghazal maestro, Talat Mahmood. Remember some hit ghazals of Rafi like Hum Be Khudi Mein Tumko Pukare Chale Gaye from Kala Pani. Hui Shaam Unka Khayal Aa Gaya from film Mere Hamdam Mere Dost. Hui Shaam Unka Khayal Aa Gaya. Rafi could sing high octave songs like Chale Aaj Hum Jahan Se from film Udan Khatola. Chale Aaj Tum Jahan Se. O Duniya Ke Rakhwale from film Beju Bawra with equal mastery as he could sing the lowest octave. Remember, Aaj Ki Raat Ye Kaisi Raat Ke Humko Neend Nahin Aati from film Aman or Main Gaun Tum So Jao from film Brahmachari. Similarly, he could sing any variety of songs, whether a Qawwali like Parda Hai Parda from Amar Akbar Anthony or a patriotic song like Kar Chale Hum Fida from film Haqeeqat or a comedy song like Hum Kaale Hain To Kya Hua Dilwale Hain from film Gumnaam or a tragedy song like Kya Hua Tera Vada from film Hum Kisi Se Kam Nahin, etc. Kya hua tera vada. Mohammad Rafi's potential as a singer was not hidden. Hence, even his die-hard critics had to bow and salute his genius. IFS Here Under explains how Rafi proved his genius and the film industry acknowledged Rafi as an unparalleled genius. Let's go back to the 50s when Raj Kapoor was ruling the roost. Raj Kapoor and Mukesh shared a unique combination. Mukesh sang all the songs picturized on Raj Kapoor and was recognized as his voice. However, in a few films, Mukesh had to back out as he could not sing certain high-pitched songs or challenging songs. Hence, Raj Kapoor had to invite Rafi Saab to sing such songs. Remember the song? Main zindagi mein har dam rota hi raha hun from film Barsaat. In the film Chaliya in 1960, all songs were sung by Mukesh. But the last song was sung by Rafi Saab, which was picturized on Raj Kapoor. The song was Gali Gali Sita Roye Aaj Mere Desh Mein. Duniya walo ek Raj Kapoor always invited Rafi to RK Films whenever the demand for a Rafi song arose. Like Ramayya Vastavayya from Shri 420, Nanne Munne Bacche Teri Mutthi Mein Kya Hai from Boot Polish, or the super hit song Ye Mera Prem Patra Padkar from film Sangam. What is more shocking is, Rafi has also given playback to singer Kishore Kumar. Shocked? It may be stunning. But the truth is that when Kishore Kumar acted in films, he had to take playback singing of Rafi when he was in a tight corner to sing a rag-based classical song. Mohammad Rafi sang for Kishore Kumar in the film Ragini. The song was a classical number, Man Mora Bavra.
Man Mora Bavra.
The other hit song that Rafi sang for Kishore Kumar is Ajab Hai Dastaan Teri Ae Zindagi Kabhi Hasa Diya from film Shararat. Rafi sang in other films for Kishore Kumar like Baghi and Shahzada. Mohammad Rafi's versatility as a great singer came on the horizon during the Rajesh Khanna era. Rafi's authority as a singer par excellence can be gauged from the fact that in the 70s, when Rajesh Khanna became a phenomenal superstar and his jodi with Kishore Kumar made waves, Rafi still dominated the scene. True, the list of his songs declined, but Rafi's status as an incredible singer remained unbeaten. It was during the 70s, Rafi's versatility as a great singer came on the horizon. In most of Rajesh Khanna films, when Kishore Kumar lacked the skill to sing a difficult song, Rafi Saab was inevitably invited. Remember Rajesh Khanna's hit film Hathi Mera Saathi? The film had all Kishore Kumar songs. However, the climax song Nafrat Ki Duniya Ko Chhod Ke was sung by Mohammad Rafi. Wanna know why? Well, music director Lakshmikant of Lakshmikant Pyarelal fame, in an interview informed, the song was initially to be sung by Kishore Kumar. But after many retakes, Kishore Kumar was dropped as he was not able to render the emotional pathos that the song demanded. Hence, he suggested the director M. Thirumugan to hire Rafi Saab for the song. But the director declined. He insisted on Kishore Kumar as Kishore Kumar was the star singer. Lakshmikant added, since Kishore Kumar was not able to bring out the heart-rending sentiments of the situation, hence we decided to delete the song. When Rajesh Khanna came to know that we have planned to delete the song, he was angry and convinced the director to hire Rafi Saab. The director agreed. Interestingly, when the film was released, the song became the most successful song of the year. Later, Rafi sang many songs for Rajesh Khanna, like Ye Reshmi Zulfein from Do Raaste.
Ye Reshmi Zulfein, Ye Sharbati Aankh.
Gulabi Aankhein Jo Teri Dekhi, Sharabi Ye Dil Ho Gaya from The Train. And Yun Hi Tum Mujhse Baat Karti Ho from film Sachcha Jhoota. And many others. This was our tribute to the legendary singer Mohammad Rafi. I hope you liked it. Namaste.
एंटरटेनमेंट इंडस्ट्री की सभी अपडेट्स, न्यूज और गॉसिप्स देखने के लिए सब्सक्राइब करें हमारी यूट्यूब चैनल एंड फॉलो करें फेसबुक और इंस्टाग्राम पर.